Hello, my dear students. I'm Professor Bibu Nicolae from the University of Timișoara in Romania. We'll present now a module about mobilizing others. This module is about identifying ways in which you can mobilize stakeholders towards delivering environmental and social outcomes for your business. First, we will discuss the relationship between environmental and social outcomes and the business. The current world is suggesting that in order to make them being social and environmental oriented, businesses need to take a stakeholder-centric perspective. And that means that they need to broaden the perspective of the corporate management objectives. That is because the most companies still focus primarily on the bottom line of economic return mostly financial. And that can be a challenge to direct the attention towards social and environmental goals. Reality, there are strong barriers to go from a shareholder-centric perspective aimed towards satisfying the needs of the shareholders, mainly the needs for return on their investment through form of high profits or high profitability rate, to changing it to a more centric stakeholder centric perspective. That means that they should take into account the interests of any other actors, mostly the most important, which are affecting and their turn are also affected by the activities of the company. It is one thing to intend to connect economic dimensions with positive social outcomes. And of course, it is another one to successfully couple financial results with societal and environmental contribution of a business. And a way to do this is to be able to develop responsible startups and connect with investors, making a direct connection, because responsible startups, they came with fresh product ideas, fresh service ideas, and they also came with technologies and have strong needs, first of all, for money for development of the company and of the products it is delivering to customers. And also another need of responsible startups is the sectoral and business development expertise. While the investors, in their turn, they can come into this partnership with the money they possess and they are willing to invest. And also they can bring sectorial expertise and management knowledge and thus do satisfying the needs for money and sectoral expertise and management expertise of the responsible startups. And also investors, they have also their needs, such as main needs for fresh business ideas in which to invest and develop, and also in business proposal with a development potential. And this is come from responsible startups, which can provide the fresh product ideas or technologies. And thus, consequently, the partnership between responsible startups and investors has a good opportunity to be developed. In order to do this, it is very important for startup and owner of a creative and cultural enterprise to understand what is an investor looking for, what are their main parameters of a project they are looking in order to decide if they will invest or not. First of all, they will look to the return rate of investments, which should be exceeding 20 to 25% yearly. And for the new projects, The return rate of investment is even higher, it's 60 to 90% each yearly, and this is according to different investor preferences. Second, investors look for a combination of equity and debt instruments. Equity instruments because this is a chance to give them an above average return on investment. And the debt instruments, they are providing risk protection for the investors. Third, they are looking to finance the startup company, creative and cultural startup company in tranches, meaning that they don't want to provide the whole amount of money which is needed by the business firsthand. And they prefer to give it in several installments. Plan according to the needs of the company in a precise period of time. And then another parameter, they look for possible control over the implementation of the project to increase chances of success of the project by using their expertise, and in the same time to reduce risks related to the new project. Finally, they are looking also to the optimal investment because the investors usually set the minimum and the maximum amount of their capital involvement. And if you are requiring much more, then they will not get it. And if you require less than the minimum, they will not be interested into providing you this capital. And there is a final parameter which is related to the correlation between the correspondence between the project sector and the investor preferences. Investors prefer to invest in various sectors of the cultural creative enterprises based on their interest or the share or their owner interest, or it depends on the form. And so if you want to get money from an investor, and you have a company which is developing cultural products, then you will not look to investors which they declare that they prefer to invest in IT or in gaming or video gaming and so on. In addition, a very important group of investors is the group of venture capital investors, VC investor. Their perspective about the criteria for evaluation of a project in order to finance it are related mostly to the commercialization potential of the market offering, second to the growth potential and the project development level, the third, very important, project team quality and experience according to experts in the field. This is very, very important. And sex also, there should be some intellectual property protection in place. And of course, market orientation of the company is very important as a evaluation for financing by a venture capitalist of a new venture. So coming to the venture capital, investors, they are quite a diversified sector. However, we can identify three types of venture capital investors. The first type are the business angels, second, these venture capitalist funds, and the third, the corporate venture capital. Business angels, they are usually individual persons which are investing their money full time or part time into the companies. Also, they are investing in many companies, not in only one. An important characteristic of business angels is that they are seeking income from the business investment, and also they are oriented towards wealth maximizing. And therefore, they are a good source of capital for companies which can provide and satisfy these criteria of business angels. Next, I will go in a deeper detail about venture capital funds. Venture capital funds are private equity investment vehicles that seek to invest in firms that have high risk and consequently they have high return profiles. And they are investing based on the company size, based on its assets, and also on the stage of product development. These venture capital funds differ from other investment funds because they focus in a very specific type of early stage investment. So early stage of a company, they are investing in this type of companies. All firms that receive venture capital investments should have a high growth potential, are risky, and they have a long investment horizon to recover the money invested. Thirdly, the venture capital funds are taking a more active role in their investments because they can and should and are actually providing guidance to the management team and to the or to the owner or to the entrepreneur. And they often want to have to hold a seat in the board of administrators or board of directors of the company in order to be a part of and influencing the decision-making process. They have portfolio returns that resemble a barbell approach to investing because many venture capital funds, they are making small investments on a wider variety of young companies, assuming that at least part of them will achieve high growth and reward the fund with a comparatively large payout at the end. And so there are two types of venture capital funds, those who are investment focused and those who are ownership focused. Characteristics of those which are investment focused is that they focus on early stage investments, such as seed investments, startups, early growth, seed venture capitalist funds. They focus on expansion investments too, and they also focus on acquisition and buyout financing. While venture capital funds focused on ownership, they are mostly private venture capitalist firms. Also, a large part of them they are industry sponsored, financial investors or industry companies which are investing venture capital from their own capital. They are corporate venture capital companies. They are also state and government sponsored venture capital firms. And finally, we have university sponsored venture capital firms, mostly from what we are calling now entrepreneurial universities. Alternative for startups to mobilize resources with the support of private capital investment is to use various forms of public-private partnerships. For the small and medium to medium company which are trying to reach an IPO status, so to list it, be listed on the stock market exchange, economic development assistance can be found in three forms. The first form refers to technology and scientific grants. These are monetary or in-kind compensation offered by a public or private source to advance a specific field of science and or engineering deemed important to the grantor. If a small business technology goals align well with those of the grant, then the funds can be used further to grow the venture. Second form is government performance contracts. They are taking the partnership public-private to a step further by creating a buyer-seller performance contracting relationship between a small business and a public player. And the third form is called economic development support, and is actually the process of using public sector programs aimed at generating job growth to optimize your company's underlying business climate. On the front end of a business growth, national or EU economic development programs are bringing discount financing, loan guarantees, infrastructure support, workforce development, and labor subsidies. So this third way is also very important and provides money for very clear forms, advantageous forms for the companies interested into using them. This the public-private partnerships are involving five types of actors. First of all, there is the investor or investors who are providing the capital to service providers to achieve agreed social outcomes for the term of the contract. For example, individuals, foundations, commercial banks, community development, financial institutions. Second are the funder. Schengen is the funder who ultimately pays for achieving an agreed outcome, usually a government or an international donor institution. Third, it's about the service provider, which is delivering actually the program, for example, an NGO. Fourth actor is the intermediary. The role of the intermediary is to structure and coordinate the relationship between the parties, including the investors, funders, service providers. And finally, the fifth group of actors is the evaluator, which is an independent third party who measures and or validates the outcomes of this public-private partnership. Public investments are also very important as a source of financing. Governments, either local or national, are investing directly or indirectly with the aim of improving the productivity of the economy and the welfare of regions and localities. And there are four forms in which these public investments are materializing. First is the physical infrastructures, for example, roads, government buildings, and other facilities, material facilities, transportation, infrastructure, and so on. Second is the soft infrastructure, including the human capital development, such as trainings, financing formation programs for training and developing the skills of various categories of human capital. Then is the innovation support, research and development support, and network and support. Third way is to through direct investment. Direct investment means gross capital formation and acquisition, less disposals of non-financial and non-produced assets during a given period. And finally, indirect investment is actually made by capital transfers like investment grants and subsidies in cash or in kind made by subnational governments to other institutional units. So as we see, public investments are a cheap source of capital for those interested into using them. And because they have small or also they have no interest, and also it's no capital repayment. So the grant is money which are coming without the obligation to be refunded. And another advantage of public investment is that the capital is provided for a longer period as needed. On the other hand, on the less positive side, there is a high level of competition to access public investments. There is always a very complex procedure to access and manage and use the funds and report on their use. And also there is a long time that is taken by the public investor for examination of the application and actually assign the money to the company which is required such a public investment. Then we'll talk about some funding opportunities for small businesses at the European Union level. And as you see, we have aimed programs funding for improving SMEs' access to finance and markets. There is a special program which is do that and is managed by the European Innovation Council and the SMEs Executive Agency. We have also SMEs supporting the EU Energy's Transport and Digital Networks, very interesting, which are finances various projects related to energy, transport, and information and communication technologies. And they are provided by Connecting Europe Facility. They are managed, they are grouped together under the Connecting European Facility, and they are managed by European Climate, Infrastructure and Environment Executive Agency and European Health and Digital Executive Agency. And you can find details at the link which are provided into the small booklet and also into this presentation. Third, we have SMEs in the field of research and innovation, where the principal funding program of EU for research is Horizon Europe, which is a successor of Horizon 2020. And this funding program supports research projects in numerous fields carried out by organizations or individuals. Also, another funding opportunity is related to SMEs in the European region. The EU cohesion policy aims to reduce disparities in wealth between Europe's European Union's countries region. It is focused on investing in regions, cities, and the real economy to stimulate growth and jobs. It also addresses climate change and dependence on energy imports and aims to reduce poverty and social exclusion. Supporting small and medium enterprises is a key priority of cohesion policy. Each European Union country is responsible for managing cohesion funds on its own territory. Another opportunity is supporting SMEs in the agriculture sector through the Common Agricultural Policy, which makes funding available to small companies through various schemes, school fruit, vegetable SME scheme, promotion of EU farm products, direct payment under the European Agricultural Guarantee Fund, and also through the European Agricultural Fund for Rural Development. And as you see, there are also several other funding opportunities for small and medium-sized enterprises provided by the European Commission, like grants to support projects or organizations which further the interest of the European Union. Parties interested can apply by responding to calls for proposal under the EU funding programs. And it also uses public contracts to buy goods and services, and the providers are selected through calls and tenders. Here we have the microfinance facility, the European Social Fund Plus, for example, which provides SMEs to help them improve their competitiveness through training. There are specific funds for maritime fisheries and agricultural funds, and here are the majority are SMEs. The LIFE program for climate action, and also there are several funding opportunities in the field of development. Finally, I will move to discuss the main actors and their roles and in the impact investment. There are four groups of actors: the government, the impact investors, the social enterprises, and the society. And all these four they are interconnected when it's about impact investment discussion. For example, the government should nationally define and legally enforcing the concept. Also should implement a performance reporting mechanism and introduce incentive schemes. Should act to reduce the interest rate of bank deposits. And very important is to include social entrepreneurship and impact investment subjects in the school curriculum. About impact investors, identifying liabilities and the importance of the role of the impact investor, Another responsibility is to develop networking and partnership with social entrepreneurs. There is also an strong responsibility to be interested and adapt for new methods, to patiently wait for the financial return from their investments, and also to invest more in seed and in venture stages of the businesses. In relation to impact investment, social enterprises should have a robust business model and a robust revenue model, should show continuous commitment towards creating impact and ensuring the continuous growth of their business. They should also improve their business literacy, mostly the business skills of their management team and their employees, and also should strive to be more truthful and trustworthy and to be open also for negotiation. And finally, the society is responsible to buy from social enterprises, to encourage investment rather than depositing the money into banks. Also, society should actively promote entrepreneurship and provide the required support to entrepreneurial activities. Dear students, the time has come to check that knowledge acquired. So are you ready? I think that now we should summarize the part of this this part of the webinar. And so I will ask you a question. The question is, payment for performance contract is financed by A, funder, usually a government or international donor institution, B, service providers that delivers the program, or C, evaluator who measures or validates the outcome. Well, if your answer was A, funder, usually a government or international donor institution, then you are correct. And if not, then please go through this video again to find the right answer to the question. You have finished the module. You please click the button to download the booklet of this competence unit in order to study it in more detail and use the resources which are listed there. And congratulations, you reached the end of this course. Please contact the organization that provided you access to the course to receive your certificate. Click on the resources area available on the upper right corner for additional contents. And of course, congratulations and goodbye. Have success in your future activity or in your accessing funds for sustainable investment with an impact, social and ecological impact.